Everyone, this is Phil Young, the gentleman I was talking to you about earlier, of SOV, as in Victor, books.com. I'm hoping to get some great information from you because you seem to be very well informed. I watched just about all of your videos. Profane slave in the chat room. Does this guy think that they have the first weapon of mass destruction, which is the Ark of the Covenant?
Well, I don't understand why the Ark of the Covenant is the weapon of mass destruction.
Well, if the walls of Jericho, you recall the walls of Jericho?
This is the ancient site of Jericho.
Yep.
You remember when they was running or going around the walls of Jericho and they had the Ark of the Covenant? And then I believe it was on like the seventh day, they blew the horns and the walls just fell down.
Yep.
Yeah, so I'm thinking that's what he's talking about.
I do think they do have weapons of mass destruction, and whether it's called the Ark of the Covenant is another thing. But maybe that's the code name for it. You know, it'd be a perfect code name, wouldn't it, for somebody who's got a religious bend, who's a bit crazy, to call it the Ark of the Covenant like it was a weapon. So maybe that's what he means. But the Ark of the Covenant is buried in the walls of Jerusalem. Ron Wyatt's found out where it is, and the Israelis tried to send in priests to recover the Ark, and six of them all were found dead in the tunnels. And so I believe that they know where the Ark of the Covenant is, and nobody has their hands on it. And in terms of weapons of mass destruction, yes, I do believe they have the weapons for mass destruction already. They may not have the ultimate weapon that they're looking for, which is to just sort of destroy everybody at once. But they'll destroy it slowly by a bit with the weapons they do have.
I'll tell you what, Phil, looks like we have a caller. Maybe they have a question for you. I'm going to bring them on now.
Okay.
Okay, I like this gunslinger guy. He's a master electrician.
That's electronics.
What it's worth, I have a BBA, and then I went back and got an associate's in electronics, 394 overall, graduated third out of 118. And that's really helped me out. I was telling you about the Ark of the Covenant, and there's a double-triple PhD physicist, Nassim Haramein. And he's wrote several books. There's a lot. He's got a bunch. He's hard to understand. Got a really annoying voice, even worse than mine. But he's got a lot of videos on YouTube. And after I put this theory together, and it all ties back what Gunslinger is talking about too, and the basic theories of magnetism. But he thinks the Ark of the Covenant wasn't intended to be. It was intended maybe to do good. I don't know. But it was the first weapon of mass destruction. Moses, you got to look at these facts. Moses, you know, supposedly split the Red Sea, supposedly lit up the desert. He could have done that. So I was just wanting to know, you know, I mean, it makes sense to me, knowing, you know, the basis of physics and the basis of electrical principles, the basics of the atom. It makes sense to me what Phil thinks about it, and also what Gunslinger thinks about that theory.
Yeah, well, personally, I think that the Ark of the Covenant is a cabinet that was coated with gold, but it was made of wood and contained two tablets of the Ten Commandments. That's basically what it was, and it was designed to look like two cherubim or angels with their wings out over the mercy seat of the Ark.
Right.
And so I have difficulty with that being a weapon of mass destruction myself.
Yeah. Everything adds up. If it was just a gold cabinet made with wood and everything, why would the Israelites that got close to it develop these tumors and nausea, all signs of radiation poison, and die? What, when they got close to it.
Well, they dropped dead. I don't know whether they were given all that detail about tumors and things, really. I'd have to reread it, but I don't remember that part. I do remember somebody touching it and dropping dead. So I'm not quite sure whether that's right, and I do believe the Ark of the Covenant is still sitting where Jeremiah hid it in the city wall in Jerusalem. And I do believe that it's still there. And sure enough, people did get close to it. They say those six priests got close to it, and they all died. And Ron Wyatt had to go back into the tunnel where he'd been digging and discovered the Ark, and he found them all dead, and he said they all died of some sort of trauma in their chests. Like they had a heart attack or something like that.
Interesting.
Well, yeah, that is interesting. I mean, I agree with him. I think you're right on the money there.
And when it was examined, it was discovered to be the old quarry of King Solomon. I've been in it a number of times, and so has my wife. And we've had some very interesting experiences in this tunnel and in this cave. And by the way, it is from this very same cave that the tunnel goes 270 feet north toward the Ark of the Covenant cavern under Skull Hill. And you've known the story of the six men dressed as Levitical priests and what happened to them when they went into that tunnel a few years back.